Hello everyone, welcome back. Now this is our program, and this is actually the MIM model program from the zip file in Blackboard. And we've had one small change, I'll talk about that later. But our memory model is, we have a J0 reference to this object here. The user changed that JTextField value to Sophie. We then created another JTextField, and it's a reference to this value, to this object over here. New is how objects are created in the heap. If there is no new, there is no new object in the heap. And J1 was created with Sophie over here. I then declared J2, but I did not create a new object. Instead, I assigned J2, assigned to J1, the effect of which J2 is pointing to the same object that J1 is pointing to, and we said that that is an alias. J1 and J2 are aliases. I then asked you what would happen if I went to the J2 object and did a set text, and I used Jack because that's a really long thing to try to write out in a video. So let's look at this set text. How does set text work? Well, it's going to go to this object, and it's going to replace Sophie with Jack. No big surprise there, but then the question is, what's going to happen when I add J1 to my widget view window? Well, J1 references this pointer, it goes over to this object, and what's this object's text? What's the text that it needs to display? It's Jack. Sophie has been unceremoniously replaced in this object by the J2 alias doing the set text. And so this is what I'm want to emphasize with you, that objects are these, or an object reference is this two-pieced thing. We've got the reference, the named bit of memory over here, but this named bit of memory points to the real data in the object, which is separate and which is over in the heap. And I can assign different references to point to the same object. So I have to be really, really careful to understand which object these references are pointing to, because I can use one path into the object, mess it up, and the other object reference is by magic changed to be that new value that was done by its alias. So today we've talked about declaring object types. These are called reference types. The named bit of memory is a pointer. The new operator creates objects in the heap, and it's these objects in the heap that store the data. And if I assign one object reference to another, what I'm doing is setting up the alias, and it doesn't matter which alias I used to go change this object over here. Both aliases pointing to the same object are going to reflect the update. This is going to be really, really important, especially later on in the course, so I hope this helps.